Hi, Karen Dice here, publisher of Mortgage Currency, and I wanted to give you some of the mortgage rule and regulation updates that occurred over the last 30-day time period. So, let's start with Fannie and their 10.0 DU release notes. This is one of them that were delayed because they had to figure out how to program DU to accept trended credit. Now, usually Fannie gives us a few months notice before release notes are updated. However, this time they go into effect on September 24th, which is less than 2 weeks from now. So with Fannie's latest announcements, they've issued 5 fact sheets, but the one that I recommend you read is the 26 question FAQ. So on this Q&A, the first 15 of them refer to trended credit. So here's one of the questions. So how does the amount that the borrower pays on their credit card demonstrate how they're going to pay their mortgage? The answer is, okay, DU risk assessment will be used to evaluate how the borrower manages their revolving credit cards. A borrower who pays more than the minimum on their credit card are considered a low risk. If the borrower is only making minimum payments on their credit card, they will be considered a higher risk. However, quote unquote, it's just one of the factors that are going to be considered during the DU approval. Okay, the real biggie in the 10.0 release, however, is that DU automated the underwriting of borrowers with non-traditional credit. Those that pay rent or insurance payments, utility payments. This is huge because it means it kind of takes over from manual underwriting. Instead, you can run it through DU. Now, back to the fact sheet that I referred to. Questions 16 to 21 cover DU underwriting of non-traditional credit, and loan officers and borrowers will probably want to read this because it has a huge impact. And then questions 22 to 26 cover some of the updates for borrowers who have multiple properties. Next, Freddie. They came out with a few updates also, and there are a couple things in the 1616 bulletin I want to mention. PACE loans can now be paid off with a no cash out refinance, but one thing they highlighted was that the file itself must have some kind of documentation in it that when that PACE loan is paid off, that the mortgage is going to be the first lien. Now, I don't know where you're going to get that from, maybe the title company, but that has to be part of the documentation in the file. The second change has to do with condo projects and eligibility. Freddie's now allowing properties that used to be hotels that have been gutted and no longer look like a hotel to be eligible for approval. They're also giving lenders more leeway in reviewing condo projects. And the third change has to do with properties located in coastal tidal and wetland areas beginning December 1st. Now, properties that are subject to coastal tidelands or wetlands or setback laws that prevent the rebuilding of the property are not going to be eligible for sale to Freddie Mac. Now, just a couple of honorable mention rule updates here. Hey, the new 1003 application form has been released, and the agencies have issued 7 supporting documents to explain it to you. Now, don't get your pants up in a bunch because they have not yet provided an effective date where you have to use them. Because, first of all, the LOS systems have to get up to date. It's interesting reading, however, if you want to learn what the changes are going to be and the new form that you'll be working with in the future. My prediction is going to be at least a year from now. Next highlight, HARP's been extended again through October 1st, 2017. And FHA has extended their temporary approval rules for condo projects. So here's what happened. It expires back in April, and it's been extended another year. So FHA has issued an updated comparison chart. So if you originate FHA condo loans, you probably want to download this one. Finally, if you do 203K loans, the inspection fees have been increased from $100 per inspection to $350. So why read mortgage currency? Because getting a loan approved and closed these days is rocket science.